Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your pal Heiku here. You know what it is, it's that samurai time. We pulling our blades out, got the katanas ready, we sharpen them up. We're gonna go on another adventure through the pass. Thank goodness that Quill's kinda taught us in the dojo a little bit. We know a little bit more about what we need to be doing. Pretty stoked. It'll be pretty sweet. Maybe we can find our iron ball. We're gonna try to go on hard mode and take maybe a throwaway and hunt down some sick weapons or an iron ball or something. That's the plan. Alright. Yo, what's going on, Zephyr? Oh, we getting ready to get our butts kicked. I won't go with the blue this time. Hope, maybe we won't. Maybe we'll find some better weapons. Let's see, what do I want to take? Shuyo Toi! Tompu! Shodai Tamahikari! Takafuji! Let me get you a shout out, Zephyr. Ow, my pinky hurts. I shoved my pinky in a car door the other day because I was drunk after the Super Bowl. And now it's hard to type. It's fucked up. Let's see. Takafuji, Chigisa. I don't want to take either Chigisa's because that's my bread and butter. Let's just take the Tonpu. Yeah, I'll be alright. It's black. I've hit my hand. I've done construction enough though. I've hit my fingers enough. I'm kind of used to that shit. But yeah, it doesn't feel good. But I've been icing it. It's just stupid. Like, I thought I'd pull, like I was getting something out of the car. Or something. I can't remember what I was doing. I was messing with the car door, and I went and I was looking for something. And I went to slam the car door, and I guess I didn't pull my hand out of the way in time. And I caught like the very tip of my fucking pinky. And, like, the door shut on it. It, like, slammed, and it was, like, I had to, like, open the door and let my finger out. I was like, oh, my God. My friends are, like, looking at me like, what's wrong with you? And I'm like, bro, I think I just fucked up my hand. Watch me get my butt kicked by this first guy. Oh, dude. That's the worst thing is to do that, because then you gotta go get your nails redone. You just fuck up your hand. It's like, now I gotta go do it my nails. And then you ain't gonna do it while your hand's fucked up. Because that would suck. I wouldn't want somebody to be painting my nails or anything right now. I'm just freaking finger crushed. It's like, please don't touch my finger. Please help. Please help. She doesn't seem to like you. Fight us and you will surely die. You have some nerve. Oh, yeah. You have some nerve picking people up and carrying them around. Oh, he's got an iron ball. That's what I'm looking for. Give me the ball. Yeah! Just biting them all off. Yeah, at that point, I'd just be frustrated. Oh, he grabbed me and slipped my... Dude, that was crazy. He, like, grabbed me by my heel and pulled me down and then slit my throat. That's sick. Get out of here. I need to bail on this guy. I'll think about it. Let me go get my health. Whoa! What's going on, War Panda? Good to see you, dude. Oh, shit. Come on, kick a radish. We need more radishes! Oh shit, it's a raid from Uber! What's going on, Raiders? Uber! Welcome in, Raiders! Welcome in, everyone! We're doing the Way of the Samurai. I'm getting my Way of the Samurai butt kicked by Subahachi. He's an asshole. Get back here. Come on, get out. I freaking keeps like blocking my strong attack even after I deflect him. I'm gonna die if I don't do something right here. Nah, I'm just gonna die. Oh, Wiz Quilifa, and he said this is one of his favorite games. They said the others hide the sausage. I believe it. Damn, I lost my Tempu. That's alright. That's not a good enough weapon to take into hard mode, I don't think. Because I wasn't doing shit for damage. But yeah, he recommended this game to me. And I've been loving it, actually. He said this isn't even the good one. He said the third one's even better. Oh, it's the shit. T was asking me, he's like, what kind of game is it? And I'm like, I'm not sure how I would describe it. Like, it's not really a hack and slash, but it's just like a straight up sword fighting game. Like, you have like light attacks, heavy attacks, and you can like push them or pull them when you attack, like based on how they're moving, and it'll like deflect them. Yeah, no problem, guys. Let's start over then. I lost the sword, but I lost a pretty junky sword, so I learned to take a better sword. Yeah, there's a little bit more to it. Like, there's almost, and there's like combos. Like, you have like a fighting game, and you like, you don't get them like initially. You have to like learn them like as you play. So you'll like get a weapon, and they have like different stances, like up, side, middle, low. Some are like unique, and they have different move sets that you have to learn depending on what weapon you're using. I'm gonna take this Shodai Tamahikari out here, I think, and leave Chuyoto, cause. You know, I would take it, but it's just not going to help me very much. Okay, here we go. We're going to start fresh. The cool thing is like, you can play, through this game if you know what you're doing and you have your stuff. I'm guessing would only take you, like, maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours. The Iron Ball has a really good moveset. It's like a fist weapon. So, like, I really like it because I'm just good with it. I've been looking for it. It doesn't really spawn in normal or easy. So I'm trying to do it in hard, but I don't want to lose all my weapons in hard either. Because this game is hard. This game is hard on normal. Stop it right now. Fight us and you will surely... I'm just going to say different stuff. Watch your tongue, bitch. He doesn't look so tough. We'll bring it on and you'll find out. Oh, I hit him. Bastard! You know what? I beat Elden Ring. I have not beat this game, so... I don't know, Zephyr. Dude, he took so much damage right there. Oh, me? Come on! He's being super aggressive. Oh, he's kicking my butt! I died. So maybe Tsubahachi isn't the first person I should be trying to fight. Maybe I should leave him alone. More characters have been added to battle mode. Dude, he's a beast. He is so strong. And like, if he deflects my moves, he'll just kick my ass. Because that's the only thing I've really got going for me is like moving him around. I'm going to take another throwaway sword, but I'm not messing with homeboy there this time. I'm going to leave him alone. Because he kicks my butt. He's really not all that easy. Yeah, we're just going to leave that guy alone and we're going to go fuck with somebody else. Let's kill some regular guys and maybe get a sword to drop or something. Sorry, lady. Messing around here. Let's go in the path. I might be able to kick these guys' butts. We'll see. Hey, guys! Do you know what the Kuro family's been doing? Yes, bullying the weak, I think. Wrong!
I'm sorry.
Tomorrow we are going to turn over our foundry to the government.
Why would you do that?
Until then, keep your eyes on members of the Akadama clan.
Yes, sir.
If anyone makes a mistake, Mass Attention will run them through on the spot.
Yes, sir.
Oh, they're dumb as hell. If they look like that, they are the underlings of the underlings.
Good, now stand your guard!
I'm gonna kick y'all's butt, I don't even care.
What do I want? I want blood! And I want it now! And I want it all! Right now!
I don't know the moveset for the sword. Yeah, get on your knees, cause you're dying. Give me that sword, son. Ah, miss! I need a different move besides the pokey. Oh, that was cool. Come on. Oh, there we go. Renton's chosen. So we learned to move right there. It's just triangle, triangle. Pretty simple, but it works. Give me that fish. Yeah. Come on, Kawakami. Yeah. I know there's a move right there. Tenshin Rasenda, yeah, there we go. They drop more food on hard though. Chigusa, Abashiri. Did I really just kill them with Choya Toe? Okay, destroy this Chigusa. See, Abashiri's got a down stance. So it, when you pull it out, you hold it like down low. It's kind of crazy. He runs really weird with it too. He gone. Damn, if it didn't lower defense by 26. Destroy that piece of junk. Another Chigusa. It's a pretty common sword. Let's go back to Choya Toe right now. Until he kills some more people. So I'm gonna leave and come back. Maybe they'll respawn some people out here. I want that freaking iron ball. The innocent need their shoes though. No, they don't. Most people around here probably run around in sandals or like bare feet. They don't need souls. They've lost their souls long ago. Long ago they lost souls. Two souls, in fact. Alright, so people are gonna show up here. I'm pretty sure. There's a guy. Hey, look, a guy! Anything up that way? You can pick clans and decide. See, I just hadn't picked a clan. That guy's scared. He's like, no, don't kill me! There's two clans in this game, and there's like, you can join the side of the government or the residents of the town, because they're not really within the clan wars. But, there's the Akadama clan and the Kuro clan, and they hate each other. I've been joining Kuro clan mostly because they're rich and they got a bunch of money and they pay me and I need it. But I'll be doing the other storylines sometime soon. Is that the only guy? Okay, here's a guy. Yeah, they'd be like, oh, I'm gonna sharpen my sword. It's crazy, and they would like test the sharpness of their sword on like people. They're like, oh, I wonder if my sword's sharp, and they'll be like, oh, get that prisoner over there and bring him over here, and we'll see. And they'd lop his freaking arm off. Like all kinds of stuff, man. It's pretty Wild Wild West kind of thing. You know, that's the. I think that's why. They kind of cross over in a lot of animes and stuff. Dude, Ishikawa, just die. Give me that fish. So I want my life back. Give me Abashiri. Let's see. Is that one any good? Ah, that's the map. Ah, it's literally the same sword I've got now, but with a better durability. Oh, there's an Akadama clan. So Akadama wears red. So it's like the blood and the crypts up here. Kuro wears blue generally. Watanabe. What a nobby. What a newbie. Or is it wannabe? Is he a wannabe? He's a wantonabe. Oh, that was cool. Okay, that puts sword oil on the weapon. So what sword oil will do is increase the life increase. Dude, wonton sounds so good right now. No, don't do that. Oh, whatever. Dude, I've not really got to eat a whole lot of curry. I would love to try it. Because I like ramen and I like all that shit. Sushi. I just have not ate a lot of curry. I've not ate a lot of Thai food either. In general. I just need to find a place around me. Oh my god, all these mushrooms are poisonous! Where's the ones that don't kill you? Man, it's so weird the way he shuffles around with that sword. He's like a little old man, like walking around, like getting ready to poke somebody. Oh man, especially like freshly made ramen, not like cup noodles good, don't get me wrong, and like all that stuff's good, but like fresh ramen, like damn dude. And I'll eat my weight in sushi. Damn. Everything in here is made to kill me. Ooh, Osaka. Dude, I wish I could have ever... Dude, that sounds so awesome. Okay, the Akadama clan's up here. We could go fuck with them or join them, but they would definitely kick our ass if we tried to mess with them. So we're gonna leave them alone. I don't really know how hard their storyline is, so I'm not gonna do it on hard. Basically, what I'm really trying to do right here is hunt down a decent weapon enough to bail out of town and then come back and go to normal with it. And kick normal's butt. That's what I was recommended by the recommender of the game. Dude, I'd love to go to Japan. I need a translator though. I need to find somebody or like get a translator or something, cause I don't know a lick for none of that stuff. And I really don't want to piss somebody off. Kusan's gonna make me a yonder. What's going on, Chief? That's funny. Good to see you, dude. Just Ah, you get out of here with that shit! Yeah, that's a real sword. It's very sharp. You're coming from yesterday, dude. I got so drunk. I was telling Zephyr I got so drunk yesterday that I slammed my pinky in a car door and like shut the car door on it. And that bitch is like purple as hell right now. It hurts, dude. This guy might kill me. Nah, he got close. Okay, well, that's good to know. Yeah, I imagine they're much more bilingual than Americans are, so. See, I just expect everyone to just know their native languages, because that's how most Americans are, I feel like. At least where I'm from. Just drop this, because it'll just come back. Sequel to Fatal Labyrinth. Yo, Code's in here too. Let me give y'all a shout out. Oh my god, I can't hit shift because my pinky hurts so bad. Jesus Christ, that hurts. I want y'all to know that this is painful for me, but I'm shouting y'all out. Dragon Crystal. Some kid rolled his car through my front yard and I had to go talk. What? Did he like knock it in neutral, Chief? Chief Kunyata. Yeah, I could probably just learn the basics then, Panda. That would be enough. English is the world's language, dude. Learning English today, yata. That's crazy. Could you imagine if they went around saying that in America? People get pissed. Y'all need to learn how to speak American, because this is America. And that's how that conversation would go. Why the hell y'all playing this on my television? See what's going on. Oh, he hydroplaned or something. He blew through mine, three of my neighbor's yards. Oh my gosh. He must have had a little too much to drink. Yeah, exactly, Panda. You get it. They'd just be mad. They'd be freaking out. Like, what do you mean I should learn another language? You should learn my language. It's like, okay, bro, whatever. Stupid. Okay, these swords suck. I killed that man for no other reason than I wanted to eat a radish. Dude, did y'all see? I don't care so much about the fucking Super Bowl so much, but did y'all see where they greased the poles in Philadelphia before the game? Because they was like, yo, if these people go ape shit, they're gonna knock all this shit over and climb it. They was literally taking paint rollers with, like, I guess Vaseline or grease or whatever and rolling the poles. I thought that was the craziest shit. Dude, exactly. I'm totally glad he didn't ram through your house. That would be crazy. I can't stand walking around like that. Ooh! Do you imagine you just sleeping off a hangover because you got too drunk before the halftime or whatever? And this mother, and you go lay on the bed, and this motherfucker comes and runs through the wall and, like, hits you with a car. You're like, God damn it, I can't even fucking get drunk in my own house. Okay, we're gonna have to leave the area and come back. We're gonna find this iron ball. That is the goddamn mission. Either find a super good weapon, or get the iron ball, which is a super good weapon, in my opinion. Yeah, the lawns are probably ruined. Just tire tracks blowing up bushes and some scrapes in the driveway. Jeez. Don't let your guard down until tomorrow. I leave you in trust of Rikoto's pass. Yeah, this police officer's... Both of these dudes are corrupt as hell. I wouldn't join either of these governments. I had a car driving my house when I was home. You do indeed. Shit, and dodge bricks. Hold on. Get out of here. I don't like you. You're a dangerous character. Get out of here. Take your gun and leave. How dare you draw a sword on the police? You shall regret this. Yeah, well, like, this isn't Imperial Japan yet. So, like, get out of here. People just trying to drive through people's homes like they own the place. I think I can go over here and fight the foundry and they might drop. Let's go see what's up. Yeah, I look suspicious, alright.
Suspiciously whooping your ass!
Well, that was a cool move! Let's see if that Abashiri is worth it. No, break it. Oh god, I love the Blues Brothers. Such a good movie.
Get them!
Doku Mushi. Okay. Yo, Dokumushi's the shit! Put it on! Don't let him hit you, bro. 684 life increase. It's only got one durability, but... I need to get the fuck out of here. She accidentally hit the accelerator. It's like, damn, buddy, how hard do you hit the brakes? You just slam on the brakes? Enough to run through someone's house if you were to accidentally hit the accelerator? Well, that was just a stop. That's just an attack on GameStop at that point. You can't tell me that's an accident. People were mad about their trade-ins. And they're like, I'm sick of your shit, GameStop! Oh, I've had it! Up to here with this shit! Hey, it's the cat guy. $2 for COD? I just bought this game yesterday! Ah! Goes out and he doesn't even leave and come back. He just goes out into his car, gets into his car, and runs right back through the store. Trade in that, you punks! How's this for trade value? I like how this guy just assumed I wanted to fight because I didn't put up my sword. He's like, you want to fight too, huh? Now this is trade-in value. Nah, they watch you watch them trade in the game for like $5 and then they put it on the shelf for 30. That's the real part that hurts. It's like, yo, I could have just done that. It's like, I could have fucking... And a lot of people did. A lot of people I knew, they would not sell their games back to GameStop. They would trade them or sell them to their friends. Dude, after the way the retro market's been going, I wouldn't get rid of anything now. Because, good lord, in 20 years, it might be worth a fucking fortune. You seen a copy of Silent Hill 2 or whatever? Like, jeez, man. I used to own so many copies of those kind of games. And I just, like, sold them to my buddies or, like, traded them for other games. Or, like, I've damaged some of them for sure. Just being a shit. I've lost some. Going over to people's houses. I lost a whole GameCube and like a dozen games to a girlfriend I dated one time because I just didn't want to go back over there. I was like, yo, it's not worth it. I was like, I'm not going back. I don't care. I love Soul Calibur 2, but Soul Calibur 2 is forever that chick's now, you know. Was it one of the Wiis that played GameCube games, though? Because, you know, that might not have been entirely a bad move. The game, trading the games, maybe. Dude, I'm mad I lost mine. I had so many games that I loved for GameCube. GameCube really had some great games. I think it didn't get a lot of love for the time. Because everybody was kind of on the PS2 hype. The Xbox had come out and stuff. Get out of here, punk. Why is this guy groaning about money? Oh, I know what happens. He's particularly strong for a regular enemy, and he begs for money if you don't give it to him. He tries to kick your ass. He's like, give me 10 yen. What? You shark, dude, you're begging for money out here. I guess some life. There we go. Oh, damn. That's a little crazy, dude. I've seen some people trade some nutty stuff for weed though. I'm like, are you sure that that's what you want to do, bro? Like, I get it, but like we can just get some money eventually and get high. Like, it ain't all that big a deal. I've seen people sell some guns or trade some guns for weed, and I'm like, that don't even make sense. It just seems like a bad idea. Does not seem like a good idea. Oh my god, how did he kill me? I wasn't paying attention. I deserved that. Called me a punk. Did y'all see that? They're like, yeah, you suck. You're a punk. The whole treatment absolutely went to 100% hooch. Weed. 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 it's talking about crazy stuff people traded. And Panda's talking about somebody trading a truck, a pickup for weed. I was like, that's pretty wild. Like, I've seen people trade guns and stuff, which also is just pretty wild, to be honest. But never like a pickup. I smelled like a fucking grow house, didn't it, Panda? That's funny. Alright, start from the beginning. You know what? I'm just gonna take a decent sword and say fuck it. I'm gonna take a nice sword. I'm gonna switch outfits too. I'm going yellow. Maybe it's the blue. Maybe it's the blue. We taking a nice sword this time. Let's take this Chigi's. The sleeve, Choyote. Commerce. Back in college, I was one of the kids in the dorms, like a car in the internet was about 20 minutes away, so I would buy cheap tax-free carton cigarettes to sell trade. Dude, that's a big thing where I'm from, Chief. Like, a lot of people up north will drive down here to the Carolinas, buy cheap cigarettes, buy like cartons and cartons and cartons and cartons, and cartons, like cases. Cause you could go to like place like J.R. Reynolds and buy however fucking much you want, and they'll drive all the way back up there and sell them. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Like, I know the prices up there are crazy because I've heard them talk about it. But yeah, that's a common thing. Oh, 2 deluxe editions of Berserk. Damn, Zephyr, that's like my favorite manga. Whoever you trade that to probably appreciates those mangas. I actually have Berserk right here. Hold on. I have to move some of my shit. Actually, I have the deluxe. Those are the big ones. I have like the first three. But I have like the, I have the just the regular, like, first. That's the first edition. Or the first book for it. I fucking love that shit though, so I keep that. I've got a couple of mangas up here actually. I got some JoJo's, I got Way of the House Husband, because that shit's like my favorite. Oh, Helsing's the shit too. Police Girl. Okay. Back to the game though. Chigiusa. Krutachi, yellow outfit with the pads. He's got the zoot suit on. That's it. I'm gonna have to get toasty here in a second. Anyway, I feel myself fading. So I'm gonna fuck with this guy this time and see if he'll if I can kick his butt. Buy a carton, 13 a pop, and sell them by the pack for 5 pieces, mate. Hell yeah, dude. That reminds me of when I was in school, though, people would sell cigarettes to, like, the smokers in school. Because you'd have a lot of course, like, you couldn't buy them if you were under 18. A lot of people, they just get them anyway, or they had family that would get them for them, or they were 18 and they could get them. And I remember people would sell in, like, a loose cigarette for, like, $1. And make like a killing off a pack of cigarettes. Splat! His stance, whack. The way that his hairline is receding, whack. That goofy ass tattoo on his forehead, whack. The way that he stands when he holds his sword, oh yeah, we talked about that. Oh, anyway, it's whack. The way he treats women, whack. Me, I'm tired of fuck. She doesn't seem to like. Oh yeah, Lucy's, man. $1 in the see, that's a good way to make a couple of bucks, I think. Especially, you know, you just got a handful of money, you can go buy some cigs, walk around and look for some bum, or I won't say bum, because it's not just bums, it's just people walking around asking for cigarettes. But if some motherfucker be like, hey man, you got a cigarette? Hey man, you got a dollar? Here. Dude, I know a guy that did that too, Pano, and did movies. He would burn movies. I used to get all my old movies from him. He was like my Blockbuster. And I'd sell him weed. I'd like trade weed for like DVDs. I'd be like, yo, man, because I had a good hookup, and he didn't. Cut any loose squares? Oh, damn. Alright. I'm actually pretty decent with this sword, so. Damn! You arrogant fool! Oh, he just tripped over that body. Did y'all see that? That was funny. I did too. Fuck. Wow. I need to run, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to get away from him. Back up! Back up! Dude, he'll kill you! Gonna kill me. I did. I couldn't get away from him. So in high school, really dumb stories. I'd buy like an 8 from them for 30, smoke cap up, and sell it back to them as premium stuff for 30. Oh, that's slick. Another man I had a porn rental business. His dad gave him a suitcase with like 200 porn DVDs, and he would like rent them out to people at school. That's genius, because you could make a killing doing that as long as you don't fucking get caught. Dude, I just want to see some kid with pretty kids full of something like 50 salesmen. It's like, I can't do that no more though because of the internet. That don't work no more. Okay, we're going to go back to normal because. Hard's just kicking my ass. I'm picking on people that are too strong for me. And I don't feel like I'm finding any better of weapons right now than I am on normal. Ah, oh, I didn't mean to use Choito. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. So we're on normal now. We've toned it down. Hard's just still a little bit too hard until I get a solid. I need a solid sword. See how much easier it is? I like how she's just standing in the way. See, this is a base sword. I can kill him on normal with a base sword, but in hard, I can't kill him with a beefed up sword. He just fights. He's so much better at fighting because a lot of your deflecting is kind of like rock, paper, scissors. Okay, thank you. You were good with that sword. I like you. I'll think about it. We're just going to work on earning money and gaining swords there right now. Dude, he's fucking... I want his sword because that's how you get really good movesets. Is you find someone like that guy and you kill him and you take his sword. And then you just fight with that sword until you learn how to do it. Like, you can learn all those crazy kick moves and shit. Fuck this encounter, there's no real point. Herman Munster. Trying to think of some other stuff, silly stuff people used to do. Let's go pick on these guys. I hate that I can't skip this dialogue. Kick me. I feel you. I took one before I started. I'm not feeling it. I'm going to have to recharge here soon on the smoke. Thanks for the lurk, though, Zephyr. Thanks for stopping in and hanging out if I don't catch you again. And I'm sure I'll see you soon. I'll be looking for your streams as well. I think I seen you stream another day, but I was getting ready to leave the house. Have y'all seen the new, like, it's kind of like a Twilight Zone show. It's by Del Toro. It's like Cabinet of Curiosity or whatever. I can't remember what it's called. It's pretty good. There's one episode about this, it's kind of like that, or like, I can't make up my mind if it's more like Tales from the Crypt or Twilight Zone. Yeah, let me see if I can find the name of it. I want to say it's Cabinet of Curiosities, but it's like dark horror stories, and they're like an hour long episode, I think, or like maybe not even an hour, maybe like 45 minutes. I remember one in particular that I thought was good. It was like they're like little short stories. That he's just made into like little movies or I want mini series, I guess. But one is about this. What do you call him? I got killed right there. He's about a gravekeeper, but he's like using his job to grave rob people because he's a really bad gambler or whatever. He's like really bad in debt with like loan sharks or whatever. So he's like using his job to grave rob. But what's happening is like lately he keeps trying to rob the graves and he goes in the coffins and the bodies are missing. And the rats are dragging the bodies off, and he keeps telling the people he's loaning the money off, and they don't believe him, of course, because it's an insane claim. But it's an interesting story. It goes. I'm not going to spoil it. That's just kind of how it starts. That's like the second episode. It's really interesting. Oh, Black Mirror's good too. Let me look that up real quick, though, because I'm. At least I didn't lose anything that run. Yeah, it's called Cabinet of Curiosities. It's on Netflix. And it's done by Del Toro. Give me just a sec, y'all. Someone's knocking at my door. I'll be right back. Stuff like that. That's like my teacher showed one thing one time because we were doing like Edgar Allan Poe in class, and she had something that was like they took like a lot of his short stories that what not like so much his popular stuff, but like some of his less popular stuff, and made like little films of it that were like maybe an hour long. I loved it. I wish I could remember what the fuck it was though, or what it was called. I know they did like Fall of the House of Usher. That was awesome. Alright. We're tired of getting our butts kicked, y'all. Not good at this game.
I'm gonna have to smoke. That's what it is. I'm not on the level I need to be of smokage. And it's pissing me off. Take this dab rig out there. Let's fight this one guy first before he walks off with the chick. Bastard! I hate how you trip over corpses. There's a certain rhythm to this game too when it comes to the fighting, cause if you just start kind of slinging buttons, you tend to get your butt kicked. Can't block kicks. I can't see cause of the freaking grass. No, I need you to get your goon off of me over here so I can fight. There we go. You void, I'm at your mercy. Okay, thank you. Huh? We're good with that sword, I like you. Do you want to join us? So this is the Kuro clan. I'm gonna think about it. I probably will go ahead and join them. Then come to Kuro's residence later, we'll wait for you there. I think these are all dull swords, so they're not even worth picking up. Just break them. Yeah, but I definitely recommend that show, cause each episode's different. The first episode's crazy, cause it's like this guy, he's like a jerk, pretty much. You know, most people in those shows, that's like the whole premises. It's like someone getting their just ends for being assholes or whatever. This dude, he's like a jerk, and he buys storage units off of, like, you know, repossessed storage units, where they do like the auctions. And he gets one, and it's owned by this German man, and it turns out that he was, like, in the SS and shit, and he was, like, an occultist and shit, and it goes crazy, too. That's a really cool one. He's got, like, some really old occult books in his, like, storage shed, and that leads to some fucking crazy shit. You did not see that's coming? Oh yeah. Something about Nazis and the occult, man. They love that shit for some reason. I guess they start buying into their own bullshit so much that they're like, yeah, this shit's real too. Yeah.
This poor guy's just getting the shit beat out of him. He's not even putting up a fight. It's like literally the same sword. They are dropping money though. He gone. Hey, he gone might be worth fucking with for right now. We'll hold on to it. Abashiri, this. We'll keep looking around. Basically, we need a sword that boosts life right now, and mostly life and attack. I don't really worry about defense so much until later on. I think I'm gonna need a drink before I hit this, because I've already got cottonmouth like a son of a bitch. There we go. Oh, yeah, hydration. Does the body good. Go pick on this guy. What's up, buddy? You want to fight? Are you scared? Run. I got down my clan, punk! You're in the wrong part of town! I guess I can't pick up that sword until I drop one. That's gonna make me go around, isn't it? Oh, it's a freaking dull sword. Break that piece of shit. Damn. Sword breaker, they call me. Let me catch you out here with a piece of shit. I'll snap it in your face. Oh my gosh, these pieces of junk. That guy's got a sword. It might be worth it. Nope. I got like a weapon scroll. I've never seen that before. Hey, that Chugan's not bad. It's just, the only problem is these weapons I'm getting are like so base on all the other attributes. Let's try the Higan. One-handed. I'm not really used to doing the one-handed fighting style. I'd try it out. This is where you join. I feel like I could probably go do that after I raise. I need a sword with higher durability. If I go in there and try to fight that one guy, he's gonna break my sword. Like even if it's this sword that is slightly decent, it'll just break it because he's only got one durability on the bar. Yeah. Okay, that's kind of crazy, I'll be honest. Sora's on. Destroy it. He's gonna get away from me. I'm not gonna make it. Come on. There we go. Yeah. Well, if you're not gonna guard, I'm just gonna slaughter you. Come back here. Wimp. Yeah. think I need to be fighting the other clan members, because these guys just aren't dropping crap. Junk swords, mostly. I heard of that sword. Marasukawi. That's actually better than what I got. Night visions, you know, I've never heard of that. I'll have to check that one out. Oh, that's weird. It has a roll move. I don't know if I like that. It's certainly dodgy. Oh yeah, that sounds good. Drop sword all. Well, I'm sure as hell not putting it on that. I'm gonna have to upgrade this sword. You know, as cool as this thing is, I'm gonna drop it because I cannot use that moveset. It is ridiculous. All that rolling around without attacking ain't doing me no favors. It's a good way to get smacked in the face. Let's see, I got 14 yen. I could upgrade durability one time. This is my forge. Two yen, yeah, hell yeah, 2 yen. Afford that. So let's get it up to 3 durability and then I'll go whoop all. We'll move the story around a little bit. That's pretty good. Are you the drifter who Tsubahashi mentioned?
He has the eyes of a warrior. It remains to be seen whether he has any real skill.
Before we talk further, I'd like to see how good you really are. Do you mind if I choose his opponent?
Go ahead and choose.
Shirotoko!
Did you call for me?
See if he has any skills with that sword he carries.
Yes, madam.
I'm gonna kick your butt, Shirotoki. You wait and see. You just wait, I'm gonna do ya. A low stance. Let's go. Oh, he threw a knife at me. Come on, Sir Tucker. Talk all that big mess. Stop right there. Sir Tucker, did you underestimate him? He has pretty good skills. I think he may be useful. I've been waiting for someone like you. Well, pay me. Here, take this. 52 yen. Sure, Tuka, you're going to drive the folks out of the station, aren't you? Take him along. Oh, shit. Meet us at the shrine next to the bridge.
Okay. If we could gather more men like you, the Kuro family would... I don't know. We'd be awesome. I'm tired of talking about this.
We ain't even talking about anything. Wait a moment, dear.
He's just like, I'm tired. I've been standing. I haven't ate in 5 minutes. You know how important my diet is.
Bing, 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 bing. Sword. Dull sword. Damn, can't y'all drop anything cool?
56 yen, Jesus.
You played this? Dang, Crossgrim. You're like the only other person I've seemed to have met that has played this, besides Quill. And he recommended the game. That's what she was gonna say? That's funny. Look at your shout out, dude.
Ow.
Total Groundhog's Day. There goes my money! But how are you doing today, dude? Hope you're doing well. Someone messed me. Oh, I was talking about greasing Philadelphia's light poles. Dude, it's a hard game. Honestly, like, I've been sitting here just trying to grind out a sword enough to beat normal. Doing good, doing good. Just trying to recover from yesterday. Oh my gosh, what a day. This game, like, I tried to do hard, like, right out the gate. Forget that. Just for fucking forget it. You're gonna get your butt kicked with base weapons. I'm still trying to dig up some better weapons, though. I think of the weapons will get better if I progress the story, though, right here. Let's just do this and get some money for now. Thank you for coming, Krutachi. Now, shall we go? Yeah, I'm not gonna say shit. I'm just gonna be the silent type. I'm gonna turn this, I'm gonna take a smoke break. I'm still here, though. Very well. Be on your guard.
Yes, Shiritoko-san, sir!
You stay here and keep looking around. Make sure to keep anyone suspicious away.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm not gonna say shit. Our destination is just ahead. Here it is. We have to evict the people in this restaurant. Sounds like a job for me. They refuse to move out. Dirty squatters. Now let's go in. Yeah! Oh yeah, a lot of those dudes walk around like that. So you're a new bodyguard for the Kuro family. Yeah, when he's in fact the biggest piss ant on the fucking clan. I told you 12 times that you should leave. Who should listen to scum like you? I don't know, you kinda have to pay your bills, lady. I want you to leave this place peacefully. But if you keep saying no, then I have no choice.
Hey! Yes, sir!
What do you think you're doing? Now it's your turn. Smash the place up.
Okay.
Smash! Hulk, smash! Throw chairs everywhere! Fuck your chairs! Yeah, that's right, I hit you with the chair. I'll hit everybody with chairs! Come straight out of a comic book. Yo! Where's that old man at? I'll throw chairs at him! Oh yeah! Well, that should be enough. We're leaving now. That's enough chairs thrown at your head at for today. Yeah, that'll do. These poor people. They just got the crap beat out of them with chairs. Thank you for following orders. This is a token of my gratitude. 50 yen. Damn, they paying good today. I'll have another job ready for you this evening. Come to the Kuro resident at sunset. Until then. Okay, people should have better weapons now. Bushido Blade, you know, I haven't played it. I've seen it played, though. I'd like to play it as well. I've heard the third installment of this game is actually way better. I wonder if these guys have any good swords. You know, I've never really tried to fuck with them. Not much. I'm getting tasty right now. Or I'm trying to. I keep getting in fights. Because I can't control myself. Wow, these guys are actually pretty tough. They got a lot of health anyway. Get the fuck out of here. Yeah, just sever the limbs. There was a new sword fighting game. I think it's on Steam or something. I can't remember where I seen it. I've never played it. I've just seen it. But it looks, it's like hyper realistic sword fighting, and it's like got different sword styles and stuff. I've been meaning to look into that. And you can like cut off their arms, or like you can literally like just cut them open and they'll bleed out if you cut them right. Like, it's pretty interesting. But it's set up like a fighting game, and you just have like one-on-one duels. It looks really cool. I wish I could remember the name of it. Yeah, you like learn moves like combo. You learn like combos, but you have to like do them before you can learn them. It's weird. Come on, mommy. Both of those swords were not all that great. I was hoping they would be something special, but not how it turned out. Let's go sharpen our sword a little bit. Huh? It's done. Oh, nice. Increase by 5, defense decrease by 2. I'll pay that. So you do this a little bit and you work your sword out how you want it. I just want a little bit of extra damage right now because I feel like it's taking forever to kill anybody. It's finished. What am I looking at here? 10 and 7, 49. 10 and 7 is a good split right now. We got a fight coming up too. I really want this iron ball. Play Dory's Buster if it didn't suck. Dude, someone told me I should try to do like a I don't think you can turn this monitor, unfortunately, unless you have like a mount. They said I should turn it and play like a like a shmup. That's exactly what I was thinking. Like, that was talking about like a vertical smut. Like up and down. It would be cool. I would play, I'd like to play a shoot 'em up on here. I think it'd be cool. Monitor was my Christmas present last year. I needed a new monitor bad, and I was like, yeah, let's just go all out, spend the money, and get something super nice. Nice, I need to learn that. Ukiguma. Junk, destroy it. I don't think I'll catch that guy. He might fight me. Two hold. I get you. It makes me think of shit like, what the hell? This one, the Midway game. Damn. Hell, I'm trying to think of it. I'm fucking high, man. That's right up someone like Uber's alley, though. He's been playing a lot of shoot 'em ups lately, I feel like. Not so much recently, but... X-Men Arcade! That sword looks like it might be decent. Uratagi. I've never even heard of that sword. You know what? I like it better than this one. Yeah. He totally sold it. There we go, 600. That's what we want. Man, I've got my ass killed over them stupid mushrooms before. Like, I need a heal. You go to get one, and it's like a poisonous one. You like lose like half your fucking health in the middle of a fight, and then you just get smacked one time, and it's like, okay, I just deserve to die, I guess, for eating mushrooms off the ground. There is a freaking weapon in this game that is an iron ball with spikes on it, and I'm trying to fucking find it, and I cannot find it on any of these games. I have a feeling this guy's gonna have a dual sword. Shout out to my Hikari. It sucks! Piece of shit, might as well be a dual sword. Throw that thing in the trash can. Fuck it, I'm just gonna go do the mission. I'll go kill this guy, cause he might have, that red sword might be something. I like how they run until you hit them and they're like, you know what, I'm gonna fight now. Dokumushi. Eh. It was okay. That life gain would have been good early on, but... Yeah, come here. Where are you going? Ah, I'm not gonna catch him. Let's just move it along, sir. Oh, I know what you mean. The job. Oh yeah, I'll get you a Toko-san right away. Wait here. They got me on guard duty. You know what a guard is? I don't know, but the word duty's kind of funny. Thank you for coming. Now what I need you to do is to accompany me on young Master Kentaro's walk. Kentaro, can he like spit fire? Sounds good to me, bruh. It's a cute baby. Once he's grown up, take charges of the Kuro family. He may not stay as innocent as he is now. Now let's go. Please keep watch and follow us. I can do that. Yeah, some guy we just picked up off the street yesterday. He's totally trustworthy. Shirotoko, turn the kid over to the Akadama clan. You are Kichyo, my former master. Young Master Kentaro is your brother. If you're attempting to kidnap him, you have lost your mind. I don't care if he is my brother. Besides, I don't belong to the Kuro family any longer. Oh! Are you taking their side? Yes, I am. Alright, we'll show you no mercy then. Now, let's get on with it. Take the kid as a hostage, and the foundry will be ours! Don't let them touch young Master Kentaro. Fight with the baby! Kick the baby! No, kick the baby. Yeah. Damn, they don't give up. Are you all right, Kincho-san? Oh, Hyuga. What? They've got reinforcements. Kurtachi, take young Master Kintaro and escape.
Nah, I ain't running. I'm drawing my sword.
Come on, Hyuga. You ain't no Neji. You ain't no Hinata. You just some...
Yes, drop the baby for a sword fight. I'm like, fuck this kid. I've got killing to do.
I'm gonna kill Hyuga. Like, I want his blood for having his last name and not being any good at fighting. What's your problem? They're pretty good. Hyuga, damn it, let's withdraw. The baby's just laying in the field over there. It seems that we managed to defend young master. The mini boss. Got him.
Well done, Kurtachi. Thank you for protecting Kintaro. He also breathes fire, by the way. Your quick attack on the enemy's main forces was impressive. You do good work.
50 yen, hell yeah. I can't forgive Kincho. The fool tried to take advantage of my pity. I'll completely annihilate the Akadama clan before I sell off the foundry tomorrow.
Sounds cool, bro. Let's do it.
This music's trippy as hell, y'all. I feel like it changes based on the time of days. And if you're fighting or not, of course. Now they're just like openly fighting out in here. You better start chaining your prayer to Buddha. Now they fight in the streets. Come on, I'll take y'all on. I'll fight every last one of them.
Get sliced!
You know where you know where I learned it from, Chief? I learned the best tech. Well, to be honest, I would say I didn't even learn third partying from Apex. I learned it from Dark Souls. Invading people with and using the enemies to your advantage. Yeah, this guy's just like he's just like. One tapping me with light over and over again. Figured I learned it from Uber. Oh, is that one of Uber's tactics? Damn, I knew there was a reason I liked that motherfucker. Uber's nasty at some of BRs and stuff, man. Me and him are a nice team. Especially when we got on Apex. Because I actually play Apex. I don't play Fortnite so much. Dude. I do play Fortnite. I'll play Fortnite for sure. Like, I played with him and Steve-O and Bane and them and Digi a couple of times. Dude, he's a beast. He's good. That's why I like playing with him for sure. I was like, dude, this guy's fucking sick. It's like T's really good. Like, I play with him a lot, and he's better than I am at Neo. For sure. That motherfucker would kick my ass if it was like a fight. If you made us fight each other, he'd kick my ass. Yeah. Oh, dude. And that's the thing, Mega Man, they're not easy games. They're fucking hard. Those games are hard. I remember Mega Man 2 forever making me rage quit as a kid. Really? I've played Fortnite, hardcore, back when it first came out. Like, I have a bunch of seasons. All my skins are, season 2. or season 3. And, it's weird coming back to it now, and it has the no build, because I was so used to having build. That's I like playing Overwatch with you and Uber Code. Y'all, we make a good team. It's fun. That game's hard as fuck. It's so team oriented. And if your team isn't with it, then you're gonna have a bad time. You know, if your pizza instead of French fry, you're gonna have a bad time. What's this guy doing over here? Oh, it's the guy that begs for money. I kill this asshole. I hate him. Give me 5 yen right now, because I want money. Get out, you scum. What? Momiyama. Oh yeah, that's the thing, dude. It's so toxic, especially if you play on PC. I think Overwatch is probably one of the more toxic. For a team game, it is super, super just full of people hating on each other. It's like, dude, I get it, you might not be happy that we lost, and our performance might not have been the best, but you don't have to fucking freak out and tell people kill themselves and act like a baby and just throw a tantrum. Oh, Gears of War. See, I never played Gears that much. I played the co-op campaign with my buddy a couple of times, because he was really big into it, but I never played online so much. Dude, they take it super seriously. And the reason why that is, Cody, is just because they can't just type as fast as they want to on console. If people had keyboards attached to their consoles, they would be just as toxic. Well, my problem is, I have a hard problem not responding to it. T's just don't say anything. He's just mute him. He's whatever. I'm dude, I want to talk shit. If you're going to sit here and talk shit, I want to talk shit. It's hard for me to be just sit back and be nah, man, this guy's really fighting me right here. And let it go, because, it's stupid. Like Chief said, it's stupid that you're taking it so seriously, and you should just fuck off with that shit. Even if you're not fucking with me, say you're bashing one of the new teammates, and he's just a new guy, you don't know how to play. Dude, chill the fuck out. It's just a game. Even if it's competitive, you can get those points back. It ain't that big of a deal. Oh, shit talking the other team's different. That's different. We're not working together. That's t- to me, that's in the spirit of fun anyway. Like, you, like, as long as you're not just being malicious, I don't think shit talking's so bad. Like, dude, the groups that I play Magic the Gathering with shit talk like it's fucking a football game or something. It's crazy. Toxic child talking shit, then yells, Mom, can I have McDonald's? Oh god, he didn't mute himself. That's funny. Yeah, well, that's the thing, like, people get frustrated too. It ain't even like just getting mad at your teammates, it's like getting frustrated and like rage quitting or whatever. It's like, Dark Souls taught me good with that shit, because I used to get mad every time I lost my souls. I'd be like, dude, I just lost 50k, I just lost 100k because some asshole come in and killed me or whatever, and now I have to grind out all that stuff. And it's like, dude, it doesn't matter. You're playing the game to play the game and enjoy the game. Oh shit, I did not mean to come here. It's not about the points. Like, fuck the points. It's nice. It's part of the journey. Exactly. It's like, I've done really well in Apex, and I've had some seasons where I didn't do shit because I was playing with my friends and I just didn't care and it didn't matter because I know where I stand on my skill level, and none of those imaginary points make a fuck. It doesn't make a fuck. Runes. Now, yeah, like I said, it'll drive you nuts. Like, especially if you're not used to it. Like, losing all your stuff. But, like, that's just part of it. That's what makes it interesting. It's what makes it challenging. We can't trust your answer. You have to die. Hey, we don't need to kill him. You fool! Suppose he tells someone. You'll be killed by tension too. That's true. Prepare to die. Okay. He's 2-on-1 me? Madam Murasaki! What are you doing here? My assistant told me that you had left, so I come here to see what you were doing. What have you been doing with Inokashira at such a late hour? They had a secret meeting. I'll report this to Matt to Master Tension. Don't do that. I would put an end to the Kuro family. Mm-hmm. What do you mean? If I hadn't made a contact with Inokashira, the negotiations for sale off Foundry couldn't have proceeded. What have you ever done to help support the Kuro family? You've never lifted your hand to help the family. Shut up, you bitch! Oh! I don't expect you to understand. Oh, no! What? Inokashira, we have no choice but to kill them! Okay, so it's a 2-on-2. She is so evil! Kutachi, on behalf of Master Tension, I'll punish those two! Let's kill him. I don't trust her anyway. She be doing shady stuff. Get out of here. Jose, where are you? Oh god, not this big bastard. Now, I'll kill this one. Whoa. Why must I die? Cause you get punished for being a traitor! Ina Kashir is dead. Let's take out Jose. Bastard, you are sentenced to death! Jose is tough now. If you fight Jose with the other guy and you don't have help, he kicks your ass generally. I like to think that Jose is the other guy's like gimp that he keeps around. They really like each other a lot. They're like into it. And they work for the police. Alright, Shirotoko, we killed him. We've done justice, didn't we? Yeah. No, I did nothing wrong. I regret nothing. I regret nothing either. We killed the fuck out of these guys. I obtained information the Akadama clan would attack our foundry tomorrow. You should fight at our side to repel their attack. I just saved Shirotake, dang. He owes me one. Does this guy have a weapon? I know she does. Let's drop this Umanawami or whatever. Ayazome. What's it do? It's got a lot of durability. Not all that great right out the rip, though. The attack down is just weird. It probably has a unique moveset. Jirokumon. Okay. Plus 500 life. Let's take as many unique swords as we can with the nice sword, Aizome, and we'll just work on them. That was crazy. That was a rough fight. You get a bunch of bullshit with Kuro clan. Akadama clan seems like they'd probably just be straightforward. These guys be backstabbing each other. Thank you. Yeah, yeah. Thanks for hanging in here, Zephyr. Thanks for chilling with us. And I'm sure we'll catch you around soon. I'll give you a shout out real quick. Wow, sword that lowers your health. That's just bull. Tompu. Meh. Maybe that's what I'm doing wrong. Maybe I need to like throw a kick in after my attacks. That may change up some shit. Oh, I can believe it. I feel like they generally enjoy fighting games. I don't know, I guess they can relate to, like, the violence or something? I don't know. Yeah, the PvP. The trailer parks be like that too. They love fighting games. It's pretty much the same culture though, in a way. They're more into the sports game genre. That's funny. I'm wondering if these guys are just gonna infinitely spawn in big trouble right here. I'm just not sure. Yeah.
Oh, he killed me! Fuck! Damn.
That's what I get.
I'm probably going to have to call it right there, unfortunately. I've got to do dinner and everything. But I'll probably get on later. I'll see what's going on. But thank you, everyone, for coming in and chilling. As always, you know, Chief Code, Cosigrim, War Panda. I'm sure there's more. I know Uber with the raid. You know, always appreciate that, dude. Y'all are always awesome and welcome here anytime. Yeah. Let's see. Who am I gonna raid here? Yeah, thanks for hanging out, Cosigrim. We'll be right back.